I'm a reckoning change and taking a train back to the mound. This big city life's done got me down. You'll all be raving, you're gonna be leaving in the morning. I'm a reckoning change and taking a train for Virginia bound. I'm a reckoning change and taking a train for Virginia bound. Thank you. hard to be a slave. Well, honey, life's too short for you to worry me. You're gonna find you were wrong and your loving good lady's gone. But baby, you don't know my mind today. Yeah, but I said, baby, you don't know my mind today. From the Bluegrass metropolis of Chicago, Illinois. Oh, yeah. That's where all the bass players like him come from. Yeah, boy. He's been with us 2.5 years, does a good job, plays the bass, sings the third part when we need it, and the fourth part when we don't he, Joe?
That's right.
Yeah, man. Charlie does a good job, he'll play the bass for you, and I tell you what, I guarantee you, if you'll talk to him long enough, he'll prove to you you're related to him, one way or another.
Yeah, one way. I guarantee you that somebody in here, your great-great-great-grandmother's aunt, sat on the same rock in Massachusetts as his great-great-great uncle's sister.
That's right.
And he still got the rock.
I tell you what, he'll trace her back to 1492 when Columbus sailed the ocean blue. His people swim over here before Columbus ever got here. Yeah, they done it, I'll guarantee it. Put your hands together and make him welcome all the way from Chicago. That's old Charlie Longman.
Now I came home the other night, I came in at one. The moment I walked through the door, she blew up like an atom bomb. All over, over, get on over, don't give me no bow wow. How I love her dear. She came to visit for a week and she's been here 30 years. So roll her over, get on over, don't give me no bow wow. Roll her over, get on over, I'm in the doghouse.
And as of September the 21st this year, that'll mark 3 years that she even was on the full-time retirement plan with this group. Because, boy, she got me treed, I'm telling you. Oh, yeah. This little lady's in my right arm. She does so much behind the scenes, keeping our little show going up and down the road. She even gets out of the bus and tells me which tree limbs to drive around, don't she?
I did, yep. Didn't I?
Sure.
Yeah.
She can sure do that.
Cindy helped, though. She got us in.
And I tell you, she tells us which how we ought to do things and which way we ought to go and
where
to go a lot of times. Put your hands together and make her welcome all the way from Bowling Green, Kentucky, where they raise corn and taters and Corvettes. She is your current 2022 Spigma Fiddle Player of the Year. Make her welcome my little sweetie, Miss Mary Rachel! Song now. This is one she's got recorded in her award-winning album for 2018.
This one traditional bluegrass fiddle album of the year from the National Traditional Country Music Association. We're proud of her for that. And honey, this is my favorite song on your whole entire album. It really is.
You like it?
I love it.
Well, I do too. I like this song.
Well, I think the way you sing it's just absolutely perfect. It's a positive representation of your vocal quality.
Thanks.
It's a
big word. These are big words. It, now, let me ask.
Yes, ma'am.
It has nothing to do with you playing the guitar on it, right?
Oh, no, no. All that hot stuff I done on the record, no.
You're not going to do that?
No, I'm not going to do none of that here today.
Okay. Why
not? Noelle, I made my mind up when I got... Have you not heard some of the guitar players that's here?
Well, yeah.
Boy, that... I tell you, old Dwayne up here is here with Fast Track. Yeah. Maybe that boy can play a guitar.
He can.
He knows a lot of stuff so far and beyond, and I know... Josh Crow was here yesterday, buddy. He's a fine one, too.
Russell Moore's going to be here.
Oh, Russell Moore going to be here. And I ain't going to come up here and show all them boys up, so I'm just going to have to do it. It's simple. I just got to get it down there like I do.
At least
it.
You're humble.
I am. Yeah. It's hard to be humble. I'm telling you. All right, here's Miss Mary Rachel and the Tennessee Flat Top Box. Here we go, boys. Such a good job. I'm gonna play you a little song right now. Honey, I'm gonna dedicate it right to you, Mary. Staying up there in Virginia and working in that coal. He wanted to head that to Nashville, Tennessee with that guitar and just see what would happen. We've got this recorded in our latest album from Rebel Records, and we hope you'll enjoy one called Brand New, hit in Nashville. I'm writing the song. Send me one person in such a package, Joe. I think it's every man's dream in the world. And the Lord just sends you an angel. And he sent me one. Unless days when she's the devil, but you know. She's heavenly. She's heavenly. But honey, I still love you though. Don't I, Joe?
Yeah, oh Lord, yeah.
You can just see it, can't you?
I can smell it.
Oh, me old my. We'll keep things moving right along. I tell you what, before these boys get too wound up, I want to tell you, there's a guy back there when we got our stuff set up. He told me to tell you all this. I told this story a few weeks ago when we were down in South Georgia playing. And a friend of mine is a Baptist preacher. He's a good man. I've thought the world of him for many, many years. And I run into him the other day at the flea market. I go to the flea market a lot on the weekends when we're home. And he got telling me this story of something that happened to him. He's actually, one of his best golfing buddies is a Catholic priest. Well, they've always for years just, you know, agreed to disagree and went right on it, both in different fields. And, you know, naturally, religion being something you don't talk about like that, they just agreed to do that. Well, a few weeks ago, they was out on the golf course, and Catholic priest, he said, you know, he said, I want you sometime to come and just go to church with me. He said, and I'd like to do the same with you just to sort of get some insight on the way you do things. He said, well, that'll be fine. Well, Sunday rolls around, and my buddy, the old Baptist preacher, he goes to church with the priest. He said, I just want to sit and watch and see how you do things. Said, I know it's a little different than we do. So they go in and sit down, and of course, it's time for confession. And first person, they come in back there, and he said, we'll just sit back here where you won't be able to see me or you, either one, and you just observe. First person comes in, and he said, Father, forgive me. I've sinned. He said, okay, what did you do? He said, well, three times this week, I told a lie. He said, well, you're forgiven. He said, just put $5 in that box as you leave. The fella put some money in, down the road he goes. Next guy in line comes in. He said, Father, forgive me, for I have sinned. He said, well, what did you do? He said, this week, three different times, I stole. He said, I took things that didn't belong to me. He said, well, you're forgiven. He said, just put $5 in that box. About that time, phone rings in the back of the church, and they come get the Catholic priest, said, come on. Said, if you don't mind, you got to take this call right now. It's an emergency. He looks over at the Baptist preacher and said, you think you can handle this for a few minutes just till I get back? He said, oh, I don't think it don't be too much trouble. I've been watching. Well, in a few minutes, this lady comes in there, and she says, Father, forgive me. He said, I've sinned. He said, all right, what did you do? She said, I've committed adultery two times this week, and I'm ashamed of it. He said, well, honey, you're going to have to go back and do it one more time, because around here they're running a 3 for 5 this week. Folks, how many of you, this is your first time seeing the Kody Norris Show? Oh, wow. How many of you, this is the last time? Well, we've got a few honest people. Where y'all been? Since we're in the hand showing mode, I do want to ask you, how many of you have had the opportunity to see the Farm and Fun Time Noon Show? We got any out there? Oh, man, we got a bunch. Any of you that haven't, each and every Friday from noon to noon 30, we work with the fine folks at Radio Bristol to bring you the Farm and Fun Time Noon Show. That's a recreation of a live 1940s broadcast through the fine folks at Radio Bristol. It's absolutely free. And it is through their Facebook page each and every Friday from noon to noon 30 Eastern Time. We invite you to tune that in, and we certainly hope you'll enjoy that.
You know what? We've got some people from Florida.
Yep.
And Texas that watched that show and found out we were going to be here.
Well, I am so glad to have all of you here and with us today. You've come a long way.
Let's do them another.
We sure do. Thank you. We're going to feature another song from our record right now. This is a true song about Josiah Tyree's uncle. He was an entrepreneur in Middle Tennessee, started his own business at 12 years old, worked in the same profession till the day he died, and made a small fortune. We'd like to sing you one about him right now. Hope you'll enjoy Uncle Bill Steele, all right. Words to tell Uncle Bill, I need a refill, that's all I've got to say. I hush up my mug to fill up a jug, and I'll be on my way. I went to see Uncle Bill the other day, and it'd been a week or two. I hadn't been there long, and he said, had a jug of good old Mountain Dew. Said, come on in and set a spell, we'll spin a yarn or so. Well, I ain't got time to draw none, I'll just take my jug and go. Where'd you tell Uncle Bill, I need a refill, that's all I've got to say. I hush up my mug and I fill up my jug, and I'll be on my way. Thank you.
Grandma's got some groundhog's chin. And never sneak off to the hollow and get your mountain in. Could pay some a bill for the invite, but I gotta be on my way. But I'll be back in a week or two, and I got more time to stay. Where's the deal of a bill? I need a refill, that's all I've got to say. I hush up my mug and fill up the jug, and I'll be on my way. I'm feeling fine, ain't ailing none at all. Next time I bring my missus, just to y'all some with you all. Where's the deal on the bill? I need a refill, that's all I've got to say. I hush up my mug and I fill up my jug and I'll be on my way. I hush up my mug and I fill up my jug and I'll be on my way.
Bye.
Country sounds still at the sawmill. On it feels still a magic shine. It was the best of all our mountains. And used to have him all the time. I'm going back to the mountains where the wild bluegrass grows. I'm going back to see my daughter that I left some years ago. Yeah, Johnny, go!
Show tonight at 8, and it'll be different. Everything we'll do on it's going to be different.
Oh, they've seen nothing yet.
We don't even know what we're going to do. You always want to come to the second show, because on the first show we kind of know what we got going on. The second one we have no clue.
Ma'am, Rachel, grab your mandolin if you would. We're going to do you one right now. This one back in 2020 and early 21 was certainly a big hit for us, and it got into Bluegrass charts and managed either through Bluegrass Unlimited or Bluegrass Today. It hung right in there about a year with us, and we really appreciate that. And thanks to all the DJs all over the country that spun this one for us, and sure did appreciate it. This is a true song now. This is a true life account of a sad, broken-hearted, down and out, tore all to pieces, ultimately nervous, soon to be groom. And I was him.
He got over it.
We put this little song together. We hope you'll enjoy. It's a fun little song. One entitled Love Bug.
One, two, three, four.
this year got me a wife. Now the rest of my life I'll never be the same.
Being down in all this pretty country today, and especially with playing in a barn, that's one song of ours that does come to mind. This is our latest single on Bluegrass Radio. We've got a music video to it. You can go to YouTube and find that, see all of what was going on that day. And we'll do it for you right now. We got anybody out here that's a farmer or come from a farming family? We got several. I want to send this out to all of you right now. I grew up in a tobacco farming family in East Tennessee, so I know all too well all the ups and downs of that hard work, and I didn't like it none. But boy, when I got over it, I quit.
You did.
Happiest day of my life is when the state of Tennessee and the federal government said they was going to buy out all that tobacco allotment. That tickled me to death. No more of that. No more. Bye-bye tobacco.
Yeah.
Yeah, boy. And see, Joe, just think how much more you'd have chewed if you'd have known me back then.
I know it.
I'm telling you. Had to bring her to you with a bell. We hope you friends enjoy our new single, one entitled Farming Man. Here we go.
Now she's gone and I don't worry, Lord, I'm sitting on top.
Charlie, Charlie.
Yeah.
You ever heard that joke about the sky?
I don't think I have.
That's too far above your head anyhow.
Well, last night, I lay sleeping, I dreamed I held you in my heart.
Cindy, thank you so much. We appreciate it. We'll be back about 8 o'clock tonight and try to do it for you all over again. We're going to leave you with one now. This one sure bought a lot of biscuits around our house the last several years. And Mary Rachel twisted my arm enough till I finally even went to school. So now I'm official. I've got the card and the paper and the plaque on the wall. Says I can do her legal. Can it, Joe?
Yeah, boy.
We hope you'll enjoy a little thing. We retitled it and called it the Bluegrass Auctioneer. We'll leave with this one. Good afternoon to you and God bless you. Hey, hello, Ryan, sir. Hello there. What do you want to get for it? There was a boy in Arkansas, and he wouldn't listen to his ma. She told him that he should go to school. He'd sneak away in the afternoon, take a little walk, and pretty soon he'd find him at the local auction barn. Then he'd stand and listen carefully, and pretty soon he began to see how the auctioneer would talk so rapidly. So he said, oh, my, do or die, I've got to learn that auction crime and make my mark and be an auctioneer. Third time, I'd have been a little bit of 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 a little bit His pal behind him behind the barn to work it up in all the storm and trying to imitate the auctioneer. If Pap said some of this can't stand to have a mediocre man, it's a fact that auctioneer used an awkward name. So I'll send you off to auction school, and then you'll be nobody's fool. You'll take your place among the men. 35, but a bit of little, but a little, but a bit of give, but a make a bit of long, but a long, give a bit of you, a bit of a little, but a bit. Pony, and a bit of little, but a bit of give, but a make a bit of 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 a time, Miss Mary Rachel, how about it? One more time, Charlie Longman back here in the bass fiddle, all right. And a pig in a pipe for you, doing an absolutely phenomenal job. How about it for Josiah Tyree? From the boy that went to school, a grew a man that plenty of cool, he came back on the hoof and auctioneer. And only the people came were mile around, and he heard him make the rhythmic sound of their hearts in such a happy cheer. Then his fame went out and shown his story, and all he could do and more, he had to buy a plane to get around. Oh, now he's a-hopping on the land, let's all give that man a hand. He's the best of all the auctioneers. All right, bud, let's sell it and get us a cold drink. Folks, you've been wonderful. I love you. I'll see you back tonight about 8 o'clock. All right. Bye.
off and you ought to give a video in a bit of a little bit of a 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 so the man back there at the White Post, $35.
Yeah.
Y'all hear that? Yeah. All right, we'll just leave it right there. Check. All right, I think it's, nope. It's almost out there. Just bring her back down a little bit where you had it there. All right, it's coming out. It's getting there.
That's where it's ringing.
One, that's in there, two, three. All right, let's try it. Y'all ready?
Thank you.
Since I was just a little boy, and there's a man come up one time and requested this. Name the songs, Hold What You Got. He said, you boys know that Hold What You Have? I said, I believe we can do it for you. Here we go, hope you like it. Swallowed them. Mm.
I swallowed a bug or what I've swallowed.
Jesus, send me to the rescue.
I've got a frog in my throat.
Yeah.
He's sort of hopping around. I think I'll just let him walk down. I'm going to wait this out till she gets here. It'll be a lot better.
What are you going to do?
Well, for now, I'm going to stand here.
No, after that.
Oh, I'm going to sing then.
About what?
I'm going to sing one about an old girlfriend of mine.
I don't want to play with it. I don't want to play on it.
You ain't going to play on it? Well, you can't stand her no way. There ain't no sense to learn a song, too. Oh, thank you. All righty, thank you. Drinking on the job. Sorry about that. Me and my frog apologize to you. All right, Joe, how about a little of Matt and Rosalie? All right. We're going to do you a real old-timer. This one goes plumb back in the 1920s, and is a real popular number in country music and old-timey music and even some old pop music of the time. And me and Joe's got a little duet for it here. We hope your friends will enjoy one called Riding a New River Train. All right, you ready, Joe?
I'm ready, Cody.
Same old train that brought me here at Sugar Bowl.
darling, you can't love one. Oh, darling, you can't love one. Can't love one and have any fun. Oh, darling, you can't love one.
Oh.
Thank you so much. Folks, we got a special guest we're going to bring up right now. And I tell you what, I've been knowing this fella a long, long time. And certainly back when I was first getting started in bluegrass music, he was working with the James King Band at that time. And I tell you, in my opinion, one of the finest tenor singers ever with James King at any time through his whole career. This man could sure cut it and get the job done. And he fronts his own group now and doing very, very well. He travel all over the world. And good to see him here today. We're going to make Kevin Prater welcome, would you? We're going to get Kevin to come in and sing a trio with me and Josiah. And oh, we've got so much on one stage for you now. It's going to be a lot, I'm telling you. It's going to be fun. Kevin, you doing all right?
Well, Cody, I can't complain, brother.
Well, good, good.
I want to say something right quick about these people up here. I'm going to start out. I want y'all to give Mary Rachel another big congratulations. That's the 22 Stickler Fiddler of the Year and one of the best traditional fiddlers there is. This young man right here, I can honestly say I've known him pretty much since he was a child. I watched him grow up in the music, and traditional bluegrass music is very safe as long as this man right here is around. He's one of the best.
Kevin, let's see if we can get that Lonesome River. You kick it, all right.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
I sit here alone on the banks of the river. The lonesome wind blows and the water rolls high. Thank you.
Folks, you won't find me in bluegrass today. It's still got that good bluegrass high voice like that, but old Kevin from Flat Cutter. That is for sure. All right, we're going to get Charlie Longman and Josiah to sing in old Standing Brother number now. A duet. We hope your friends enjoy one called The Sweethearts in Heaven. All right.
Try it again, Joe.
don't think that I'll be hanging around while you're having fun. I won't sit here to cry no over you. Run down and you step out and tell you what I'll do. I'll lock the door and I put out the cat and I won't step into the room. Well, I won't step into my honey, I won't step into. I lock the door and I put out the cat and I'm gonna step into the show. Side.
I'm ready, boy.
All right, here we go. Hope I don't again. Folks, I want to remind you, do come by back there to the merchandise table. We've got all kinds of good merchandise back there. Come by and check it out. I want to remind you something we have got. It is a little bit cold out there tonight. And boy, we'd like to just get rid of them here because we need room in the bus. We've got a bunch of hooded sweatshirts back there, or hoodies as a lot of people refer to them as. Look at that. Look right there.
Come here.
Come here. Come here. Come here.
He said, no, no, no.
Give her a round of applause.
I'll give her a round of applause. Come on, check it out. We've got all of her. Oh, thank you much. Thank you. Give her a hand. Give her a hand. Thank you so much. But we've got all of our latest albums, some t-shirts, caps, all kinds of different things back there. And if your neighbor's talking too much for your liking, I've even got some clothespins back there, I'll sell you. So do come by and check that out, and I know it'll be a good thing for you. We'll get right back into the music here. How many more we got, Cindy? Okay. All right. We'll do you a couple of more, and that'll be all we'll have for this. Oh, me old my Joe, put her up there in the fourth notch from the little end.
Uh-oh.
I don't like that chord.
You don't?
I don't know what that means.
Folks, if y'all had a good time with the Kody Norris Show. Yeah. Oh, wonderful. We always look forward to getting the head out this way. Folks, I do want to remind you, coming up next Saturday night, this is big doings. This is my annual homecoming performance in Mountain City, Tennessee at the Heritage Hall Theater. Do check that out on our website, thekodynorrisshow.com. Any of you like to come up and be with us, you'll certainly have a good time. We have a wonderful, wonderful little theater there in our town. This is about the 14th year that we've done that, so do come out and try to be with us if you can. Also, the following week, we'll be at Silver Dollar City in Branson, Missouri. And I tell you, we've got a whole lineup. Check out our website, thekodynorrisshow.com. And friends, also, don't forget the Farming Fun Time Noon Show. I want to see all of you tuned in with us this coming Friday. So do tune into that and keep that in mind. All right, we're going to do the title track off of an album back there. We hope you'll enjoy the story of what I've been trying to do for many, many moons. Little thing entitled, When I Get to Money Made. Oh, and every time I think about my little Emma Jean, I find a little deeper in love. And she just took and told me, finna give her the brain. I had another one I'm thinking of. Money, money. Woo! All right, absolutely wonderful. You've been a wonderful audience today. Have you enjoyed the Kody Norris Show? Yeah. Would you like to maybe see us come back one of these days if we can? I sure hope we can. Huh? We've had a wonderful time. We'll see you on down the line, another place, another time. Do remember our website, thekodynorrisshow.com. We'll get Josiah Tyree to kick us off on the last number. I want to clarify something, by the way. Back at the record table a while ago, there was a lady came up and she said, I want to know something. She said, why is it that the banjo player and the fiddle player, she said, when they're up there on stage, she said, they'll be up here 1 minute doing this, and they'll be down here next minute doing this, and then they're back in the middle. She said, I notice you and the bass player, you just kind of grab in one spot and just stay there. You know why that is? Mary Rachel and Josiah's still hunting for it. Man, old Charlie's flat got it.
It's your lie. I'll let you tell it the way you want to.
Oh, me, oh, my. Folks, right here, I'm going to sing you a song about my number one favorite thing on God's earth. A little thing entitled Roll in My Sweet Baby's Arms. All right.
break it down and clean it up. So if anybody wants to help, just stick around because
that's
there's
the
a lot
time.
To do.
Yep.
We took us from Tuesday to Thursday to put it all together, and then we got one day to break it down. So y'all stick around. That was the
Who's
going to
be here
Sunday.
Tomorrow? Hold on. Who's going to be here tomorrow?
James Bacon.
Y'all ain't no fun.
Y'all, thank you so much. And y'all, give it up for my volunteers. We've had a great bunch of folks helping us. Could not do it without them. Couldn't do it without you, and we couldn't do it without our sponsors. So don't forget, pick up that program booklet. And again, thanks for our sponsors. And see Matt Randy.
Hey, I will say one sure. thing real quick. How many of you, is this your only festival that you go to? How many go to more festivals? Raise your hands.
Oh,
all right. So the rest of you that haven't gone outside of here to another festival, we need your help to keep this thing going. Not just this one, bluegrass in general. And I don't want to say it's dying, because it's not. We just got to get more people interested in it, okay?
And we got to keep them all playing traditional bluegrass, too, because that's scaring me. This other stuff.
It is a little scary.
Yes, sir. And that's why I appreciate the Kody Norris Show!
Folks, I want you to join in with us and help us sing, all right?
I was standing by my window on a cold and cloudy day, and when I saw the hearse come rolling for to carry my mother away, everybody sang, "We'll circle me unbroken, by, Lord, by and by, fair to better on the way in the sky, Lord, in the sky." I told the undertaker, please drive slow. Oh, little body, you are hauling, but I hate to see her go. We'll circle.